sushi roll. Very funny. I still just want to play blitz though. I'm in a blitz mood today. So I'm gonna keep playing blitz, try to get back to 32 if I can. Now this is GM HellMasterpiece 3021. This looks like an Ali Reza account, but I honestly have no idea. So let's see how the openings go. This looks like an Ali Reza account. France 3021, Pro Chess League. This looks a lot like an Ali Reza kind of guy. Go here. I don't know if it is, but it definitely looks like it. It's got that look like it's an Ali Reza account. Well, I cover Levy's round three from Charlotte. I don't know when the games start, but they probably start late. Maybe they're going on right now. I don't know. What time do the games start, you guys? You guys can tell me. I go here. Yes. Okay. I have 97 as a move here. Move. I guess I'll play here. Oh, round three starts in 30 minutes. Okay, I might cover a little bit. I might cover it a touch. Let's just drop back, of course. I have B5 maybe to hit the knight. I also have A4 lurking. Do you like your headset? I need a new one. Yeah. Yeah, the Pro X is pretty good. The Pro X is great. I like it. Yay, Hikaru is back. Yeah, I mean, I'm only back for a couple of days, though, unfortunately. I wish it was more, but again, I am playing in St. Louis in a 960 chess event. So it's what it is. It is what it is. Okay, let's take the rook. He goes 95. 97 is fine. Just hit the knight. And I take with the rook. Yeah, St. Louis again. Yeah, I mean, what can I say, you guys? Okay, plays d4. Good move. Now, do I want to go? I have two options. I think I'll go this way, even though I suspect it's dubious. Although, I don't know. Let's go here and take with the pawn, I guess. My rook can always swing too, so my rook should be fine if we trade the pawns. Maybe I'm threatening to take, maybe not. Okay, goes g3, logical move. Now, do I play queen e6 or not is also a question. I feel like, I mean, there are a bunch of pieces near his king. e8, he just takes. I guess I'll go here, because now takes, I can always take with the rook, so now I can slide the rook over too. Because now the rook guards when he tries to trade and take. Versus a7, where it would be a free piece. He goes queen c2. I can obviously take the pawn on d4 if I want. Bishop d4. I mean, it feels like there should be something here for me, but I don't quite see it. I'll also just go to e6, maybe. Don't love it. Okay, I'm moving too slowly, so I need to speed it up a little bit. Takes, knight d4. I mean, that's just a draw. I don't really want to draw, so I'm going to try to reroute my knight to a better square here. Go here, guard everything. Definitely not the best way to play this, but I want to create an imbalance versus making a draw with, like, takes, and all that jam. I can again take, though. Wait, then he takes with the bishop. Let's just go back. Play h5, maybe g6. I'm still threatening to take on d4. Go here. Actually, what am I doing? My rook is getting very boxy here. Should have gone rook g6 probably and taken. Okay, singing for a long time. He goes rook e2. He doesn't see d5, so I guess I'm happy. If g6, he traps my queen, so I can't do that. I mean, I guess I kind of want to take. I guess I'll take and play d5, maybe. Yeah, d5, e5, then I have f6. I should be okay. Go here. Unless I blundered something. No, I didn't blunder anything, I don't think. He takes, I take, he takes, I take the queen. Moves the bishop, I take, and I should be fine. He's low on time. Goes bishop h4. That allows me to trap the bishop. I guess I'll go for it. Why not? Could have also just taken the pawn, I suspect, but should be okay. Take. Okay, this should just be winning for me as long as I cover all the checks here, which I do. So this is looking very good. All right, let's keep going. Unknown, but probably Ollie Reza. Well, I said it looks like an Ollie Reza account. That doesn't mean it is Ollie Reza. In fact, the way that was played, I don't think it is, because my opponent was way too slow there. Because Ollie Reza would have sped up really hard at the end. He would have gotten a lot quicker at the end of the game. That's why I'm almost certain it's not Ollie Reza. He would have sped up a lot. He would have been really, really fast. It definitely is Ollie Reza. Why is, oh, because it hasn't been used for a year. Oh, this account hasn't been used for a year. Okay. I mean, I guess I don't know. It could be Ollie Reza, but I don't know. I'm not feeling that, like, that oomph. I'm not feeling the power, shall we say. I'm not feeling that power, that oomph, that I would be expecting from Ollie Reza. Okay, I don't really know where to put my rook, so I'm just going to put my rook here in D1 and E1, I guess. If he takes, I always have rook A1, so he can't really do that. Oh, it has a photo of an Iranian football player. Okay, yeah, maybe it is. I mean, maybe it is just Ollie Reza. It has the feeling of Ollie Reza account, but the moves themselves don't feel like Ollie Reza moves. I guess I just go H3. Hey, Top Secret Cat, for the 6 months. Thank you so much to Top Secret Cat. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. Drop the juicer back to E2 here. I guess I just go rook D3. I mean, I don't know what exactly I'm doing here, but I'm doing something. Okay, B5. That's an interesting choice. Do I want to go... Actually, I realized I did have D5 there, which I should have seen. Still have D5 and takes. Doesn't look right. I can play knight D2. Doesn't look right. Let's go here, and I guess I'll just take with the pawn or the queen. Probably I should take with the queen, keep pressure on this weakness on C6. He has knight D5. He has knight D5. Looks a little bit scary, but is it scary? I'm going to call his bluff and take. I think I have knight E5 here, unless I'm insane. Not easy to prove anything here, but I feel like I should be fine. Okay, let's see. Let's go here to hold the square. First and foremost, logical move. Holds everything. No knife F4. I can always move my queen back, maybe. Looks relatively okay. Queen F5. So I've got to move the rook. I guess I'll just go here. Up a pawn, but it's not really much of a pawn because he's a great bastion here on D5. The knife can jump everywhere. So it's not ideal, but I think if I can unwind it just a little bit, I should be fine. Oh, the picture is not an Iranian footballer. Okay, fair enough. Whatever. Let's go here. Queen D3. Trade some queens. I thought I might have just blundered something. Okay, now I should be okay. It doesn't mean I'm winning, but now I shouldn't really be losing. Now I can consolidate. I've got an extra pawn here. I guess I'll go here. Yeah, rook b2. I guess I go and go rook a1 if I want, but I think I'll just go here. Knight e1 maybe. Go here. I guess I want to bring my king in, maybe king f1, king e2 at some point. Hard to prove anything. Okay, I'm gonna go here, maybe knight e3. That's my idea at least. I think I'm better. Maybe not winning, but better. Go here, force a trade. Okay, I mean, this is not going to be easy to win, but I should be better. Question is how to win this. Rook C, like a move I can take, I guess. And I have rook C3. Okay, he finds rook C4. That's actually a very good move. Got that move existed. Go here and here, I guess. Okay, but that now allows me to go here. Wait. This looks wrong. Wait a second. This looks very... Wait, I have bishop f4 and d6 or something? Wait a second. I can also check and... Wait a second. This looks very wrong. How do I win this, though? Go here. Rook c4, I guess. Very wrong. Hit the pawn. I have this check too. I think I'm winning here. And now my pawn is now. I mean, now this must be winning. Let's just go here and force a trade. Go here and bishop e3, I guess. Okay, two connected pawns. This must be winning. Go here and here. Okay, now my pawns are just too fast on the queen side. We get the win. You feel like the player is too slow to be Ali Reza? Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's Ali Reza. I don't know who it is, but it feels, yeah, it does feel a little bit too slow. Not really sure though who it is, honestly. It's Maxime? Nah, it's not Maxime either. It's someone who's like I want to say like 2675 maybe. I want to say it's like 2675, 2700 ish. It's not Etienne. No, it's, I don't know who it is, but that's the range. I think it's like 2675. That's my guess. Like Fresnay, I could see it being Fresnay. Yeah, Fresnay is a little bit slower at blitz. I could see it being him. Yeah. Maxime Lagarde, no, Lagarde's not that high rated, and I'm not really feeling that kind of power. I mean, he's a good player, but I'm not feeling the power. Just castle. You think it's Shaq? Nah, it's not Shaq. Shaq would be much more aggressive, for starters. Shaq would be way more aggressive. Okay, let's go knight c5 here. Guess I just go here. Why not? I've got a great bastion. Pawn can't kick the pony. So it's a great bastion. Great ponies. It's almost time to start attacking, but how do I attack? I have g5 and knight h5, maybe? An idea. Yeah, whatever. Let's just go with it. He might sack, but I think I just go queen c8. Okay, let's go here. I hit the bishop. I have knight f4. I have bishop c8, maybe? Expect that. Let's go here. I assume that I could play like bishop c8 and f5 at some point, although I don't know if that does much. I'll pre-move because I want to open up the diagonal for the bishop. It's 90% Essipenko. He only has two friends, and one of his friends is Essipenko, and he's a big Arsenal fan. Essipenko, really? I feel like Essipenko is better than this guy. I think Essipenko is better than this guy. Just my read. Okay, knight b3 is a good move here. I don't want to trade. I don't really want to move the knight back. Go g4, maybe. I'm gonna go g4. Probably a weird move. I want to go like h5, h4, maybe knight c6, maybe f5. Knight b3 is a classy move. Very high class move that he found. I can take both ways here, but I guess I have to take this one. Be careful. It's probably gonna turn into an all-in attack versus something on the queen side here. We'll see who's quicker. He goes knight e2, which I actually don't like. Now I think I have knight g6 and h5, h4. And I think he headed the wrong way. I think his knight needed to go here and he needed this. Okay, first of all, I have f5. Second of all, I have h5, which looks fine. h4, I have f5. I feel like I'm starting to not dominate, but I should be doing well. Okay, let's just kick the bishop first. So let's just take. Go here and f5, I guess. Take with the pawn, then I have bishop h3. Target the rook. I have f5. I'm starting to open it up a little bit here. Be careful that he might be able to have rook a3 if I push the pawn and swing. So I want it here, but then he has rook a3, rook g3. More new age chess. I can play f5. Looks so right here. Whatever, let's just do it. Add 1 of 6. I'm not running ads, you guys. We'll go here and take the pawns. I'm not running ads right now. Hikaru, you made them invite Artemi up to these events. Now Essipenko. There are too many strong Russian players. I will say that straight up. Too many strong Russian players. So someone ends up getting screwed, basically, for lack of a better way of putting it. Someone gets screwed because there aren't enough spots. There are too many good Russian players. Can play e4, queen e8. I want a gambit, but I won't. Let's just go here. It's queen h3, I just realized. Bishop d2. Okay, let's just go here. I think that's a free pawn on the rim. Is it a safe pawn? I think it is. Okay, let's go here. Try to trade some queens. Any endgame should be good. I've got extra pawns. Will I miss queen h3? That was very... Oh, I'd rook f8, maybe. Oh. Okay, let's go... Guess I have to go here. Guess it's just a draw. Maybe. Be safe here. Oh, he doesn't want the draw. He wants more. Wait, okay. But I'm low on time. Okay, let's go here. He wants more than a draw, I guess. It was a mistake, though. Okay, I go check, and I have bishop d4. Very, very, very poorly played. Check, and he gets ice skatered. And seeing like that transition at the end was also not great by this guy. So that's why I know it's not someone who's 2700. Let's go here. Yeah, 2700 doesn't just blunder like that in the end game. There's just no way. Did I change the mouse? No, I'm still using my classic Shroud mouse, you guys. Classic Shroud mouse. Classic one. You guys can see it, right? Yeah, I'm using my classic Shroud mouse. Think okay, let's just go d3 and bishop e3 here. Add one of nine. Okay, you guys are just trolling. I'm not running ads right now, so you guys are just trolling. Go here. I guess I'll go here. Maybe knight c4, maybe a4. Is Logitech a sponsor? Yes, they are a sponsor, you guys. Okay, let's just go a4. I don't know if it does anything, but it seems like a move. Play rook e1. I think I want to go rook b1 at some point as well, maybe. Let's go here. The rooks are on the ideal squares. No troll. I got eight ads less than 3 minutes ago. I'm not running ads, you guys. I'm not running ads, so I don't know. I don't know what's going on. Okay, let's go here. Maybe I don't know if this is right. Yeah, I mean I don't know, you guys. I'm sorry. I think I'm gonna go. Let's just go c4. Can also take with a pawn, maybe. It's interesting. Take with a pawn or not? I think I do take with a pawn. I think I go like knight b3 or rook a1 here. Got a good pawn structure, maybe. Queen a4, I have rook here and rook takes. At least that's my assumption. I think I have counterplay. Not really clear, though. Not clear. Okay, I'm going to go rook a1 here. Guard the pawn of knight b3, maybe queen f2, maybe knight e4 next move. Pretty good position. Am I still in Colombia? No, you guys, I'm not. I'm back in Los Angeles. Okay, he goes f5, logical. I can play e4 here. It's very committal, but whatever. Let's just do it. If f4, I'm going to take the juicer. If he doesn't, I get a jumbo pony. He's got a weak pawn, potentially. If these trade, his pawn is soft. And if he doesn't trade, I guess he has to gambit a juicer, but that also looks very bad. Thank you to Mr. Sneeze for the tier 1. Thank you to iLives Printer for the Prime. I don't know what this is exactly. I'm just up a juicer unless I'm insane. I think this guy's insane. Why am I just up a juicer? Knight c6 is a good move, though. Okay, let's go here. Maybe queen g3. He has some counterplay here, maybe. Be a little bit careful. I need, like, rook e2. I need some consolidation. Okay, rook f6 is a good move. Okay, this is actually a little bit dangerous. I have to be careful here. Knight h4 allows knight d4. This is maybe a little bit scary. I guess I'll go a little bit scary. Okay, let me just slide away. Slide out of the danger zone. Play queen h4 here. Need something fast. Maybe d4, d5 makes sense. No, that doesn't make sense. Okay, I'm still up on the clock. It's not. This I don't like. I guess I'll go here, knight f5 or something. c1 maybe, and c3 even. Let's go here. And keep the time balanced. I have chance. I always have knight f5. That's what I'm banking on. I have c3 and knight f5. These two moves, and I trust that I have counterplay somewhere in this position. My assumption. Actually, rook h6, maybe I can just go c3 anyway. He's way too slow as well. Thank you to Rice Remix for the 2 months. Thank you so much to Rice Remix. He does. Let's go here. Kick the pony out of town. If knight b3, knight f5. He takes. I get the jumbo pawns in the center of the board, which are just free rolling. Queen e5 is rook there. Okay, let's go here. He's trying to do something, but I don't think it works. First of all, I release the pressure by getting rid of one set of rooks. Now he only has he has less pieces to attack with, and now I think my pawns are just free rolling. Just keep going. Just gonna go 1-2-3 GGs, and he just resigns. Okay, let's keep playing randomness. You really think this is Essipenko? I don't think it is. Essipenko's better than this guy. This is not Essipenko. I'm just telling you guys. Okay, I don't know why I did this either, but whatever. I've like got some weird pawn roll. Thank you to Kings for the gifted sub. Thank you to Life Ends for the Prime. Thank you so much. Appreciate you guys. It's not Essipenko. I'm quite sure of that. I also have C5. Okay, let's go C5. This is very weird. Go here, develop. Okay, bishop d2, also a very strange move. So I assume I just develop here. Go here, force bishops off. This is not Essipenko, though. I'm like, if you asked me to put odds on this, I would say the odds that this is Essipenko are, like, very low. I think, like, lower. I'd say, like, 5% this is Essipenko. This guy's not playing great chess. And Essipenko very much is a standard player. Like, he has, like, straightforward theory. And this guy's playing very weird chess, so I'm pretty confident when I say it's not him. Let's just go here and target the rook. I guess I'll go here and queen d7. I did give him knight c1, which I shouldn't have. But queen d7 looks relatively okay. Also, I could have gone queen d7, queen a4 right away. Maybe it goes knight g3. Also a weird move. Go here, target the pawn. I have knight f5 here. Nah, this is not Essipenko, you guys. Not Essipenko. Can eat the juicer, but I think I should just go knight f5 and try to close the wall here. Close it up and then take the pawn and castle my king to the queen side. And trust that I'm going to win this game. Okay, let's take. A4 is still free. The juice is free here, so I think I'm doing well. Doesn't mean I'm winning, but I can somehow get castled. That's the key. Let's see. I can also go here, maybe. Yeah, let's go here to trade the knight, and then I can just castle. And I'm out of the danger zone, I think. Okay, let's take. If g6, I just take and go king f7. Then get castled here. I mean, assume I should be winning somehow. Okay, let's just castle. Go here. And queen f2, queen a2. Go here. A lot's going to hinge on whether I can win on the queen side before he wins on the king side here. Okay, it goes rook e2, so I don't want to go queen b1. a5, a4 is an option. Yeah, let's just go a5, a4, a3 maybe. If I take and check, unclear. So let's just keep rolling the pawns. Want to go a3 here. And maybe check and take the pawns, kill the whole chain. So here I have check and... Oh, wait, he's got queen e1. Forgot about queen e1. Still probably okay here, but very tricky to play. G3. Is G6 a threat here? Kind of it is. I guess I'll go here and knight A5. Definitely misplayed this. Let's see. I guess I'll go here. Queen E8 maybe. Starting to slow down a little bit too much again. here. I can jump with the pony I have play. It does go g6. Of course I should take. I can put my king on b5 here, I guess. Let's just put my king on a safe b5 square here. I can't really attack it. How do I do this? I guess I'll go here in d3 maybe. Here, I guess. My knight is also very good now. c6 maybe. Queen g5. I guess I'll just go here. This queen d2. He wants queen a2, I guess. How do I cut him off? I can't easily cut him off. I do have this, but that doesn't make sense. Okay, let's just go. How do I do this? Oh, yeah, yeah. This looks very bad for me now. I have to go here and here. Go here at b5, maybe? On the pawn. Check, I take. If I get f2. Okay, how do I do this? I guess I just go here. Check. Knight g5 maybe, a knight e4 or something. Wait a second. Let's go here. Here. There's no mate. Here. There we go. We got the win. Good win, you guys. Back over 3,200. 5-0, 5-0. Yeah, we get the McDo option. We're back over 3,200, which is exactly where we want to be when all is said and done. Very tough game. Very, very tough game. Yeah, and I did hang my knight intentionally, you guys. He had queen d8 check to win the knight, but I figured he had 5 seconds and 3,200 or bust. So I took the gamble that he wouldn't see it. And when he didn't see it, and he checked, somehow after king a6, there are just no check. There are just like no checks for the queen anywhere. So it's just winning here. So yeah, pretty good stuff. All right.